Welcome to the tutorial on Common Source Amplifier, presented by Mellow Outlook. The Common Source Amplifier is also called as the Grounded Source or the CS Amplifier. As you can see in this particular circuit diagram, the source terminal is connected to ground and the input voltage is applied between the gate and the source. The output is taken between the drain and the ground across the resistance RD. The Common Source Amplifier is one of the most widely used amplifiers. In an amplifier which is formed by cascading a number of stages, the bulk of the voltage gain is obtained by using one or more common source stages in cascade. So next, let us look into the characteristic parameters of the common source amplifiers. The main characteristics of the common source amplifiers are the input resistance represented as Rin, the open circuit voltage gain AV0, and the output resistance R0. But if we want to analyze any circuit, we need to determine along with these three parameters the overall voltage gain, which is denoted as GV. Next, let us look into the common source amplifier without the source resistance. Let us consider the small signal model of the common source amplifier, which is shown in the figure A. This small signal model can be replaced by a hybrid equivalent model, which is shown in the figure B. So you can see we have replaced the MOSFET with an equivalent hybrid pi model, wherein we have represented the input VI in terms and we have represented the dependent current GM into VGS, and that is connected in parallel with R0, and we have the resistance connected in between the drain and the ground RD, and this resistance R0 is a parallel combination of RD and small R0. So as we have mentioned earlier, we need to find out what are the characteristic parameters. That means we need to find out the input resistance, we need to compute what is the open circuit voltage gain, we need to compute what is the overall gain of the common source amplifier. So to begin with, the current that is induced in the output port, as you can see from the hybrid pi model, the current induced in the output port, that is I, is equal to minus GM into VGS. And we can compute the output voltage V out to be equal to minus GM into VGS, that is the current, multiplied with the resistance. And the resistance is given as R0, which is equal to RD parallel with small r0, and here it is denoted by equation number 1. We also know that for the MOSFET, the resistance, that is input resistance, is infinite, and the input voltage is equivalent to that of the signal voltage V signal. Also, the gate to source voltage is equal to VI. So if we want to compute the open circuit voltage gain AV0, that is computed as output voltage by input, and that will be equal to minus GM into RD parallel with R0, which is denoted as equation number 2. Now this resistance R0, small r0, it reduces the magnitude of the voltage gain in some cases. So sometimes it would be more convenient to neglect the value of R0, and in such cases the open circuit voltage gain can be represented as minus GM into RD, which is represented as equation number 3. Usually we are going to ignore the value of the small r0 for discrete circuit amplifiers only. For all other cases, we will be considering the value of the small r0. Now, the output resistance R0 is the resistance which is seen while looking back into the output terminal by setting the input voltage to 0. This we have already seen previously when we looked into the characteristics of amplifiers in the previous tutorial, and we have seen that R0 is equal to RD parallel with R0, denoted by equation number 4. And it applies here as well that if you are going for discrete circuit amplifiers, we will be ignoring this small R naught, and we can represent the output resistance R naught to be equivalent to that of the resistance which is connected across the drain, that is RD, and this is denoted as equation number 5. Now to compute the overall voltage gain, we have two things which are to be considered. One is that the input resistance is infinite and the entire signal will appear across the input. So we have the input Vi which will be equal to the input which is connected to the amplifier, that is represented as V signal, and this is denoted as equation number 6. If the load resistance RL that is connected to the amplifier output terminal, then this resistance, that is the load resistance, will appear in parallel with the resistance connected across the drain. So by using the voltage divider formula, we have the gain of the amplifier to be equal to AV0 into RL divided by RL plus R0. So continuing with the derivation, we have AV0 which is equal to minus GM into RD parallel with R0. So if you want to compute the gain of the amplifier, AV will be equal to AV0 multiplied with RL divided by RL plus R0. And we know that R0 is equal to RD parallel with R0. So AV will be equal to minus GM into R0 into RL divided by RL plus R0. That is because since this particular term is equal to capital R0, we have just replaced it or multiplied it with R0. So that is how we have obtained this particular equation. So if you look at this particular equation, this is equivalent to saying that R0, that is capital R0, is in parallel with RL. So we have AV to be equal to minus GM R0 parallel with RL. But we know that R0 is nothing but RD parallel with R0. So I can write the gain of the amplifier to be equal to minus GM RD parallel with RL parallel with small R0. And the overall gain is equal to the output voltage divided by the input signal. So I can write this as, because we have V signal to be equal to Vi, whatever value we have obtained for the gain of the amplifier will be equivalent to the overall gain, and these equations, that is equation number 7 and equation number 8, will be the same. So that completes the common source amplifier without the source resistance. We call this amplifier as without the source resistance mainly because if you look at the amplifier circuit which is shown here, we have not connected any resistance to the source. It is directly being grounded. That is why we call this as a common source amplifier without the source resistance. So we have derived the equation. Now we will look into what are the few remarks that we have obtained from the understanding of this particular operation. The first remark is that the input resistance is ideally infinite, which we have seen, and the output resistance is moderate too high. The output resistance is the one which is represented with capital R0, and the open circuit voltage gain AV0 can be high. Now, these remarks are based on the condition that if we have the input resistance to be infinite, it implies that it draws no current at DC, and moderately high output resistance implies that the maximum power transfer occurs. And if there is any variation in the resistance connected to the drain, say for example, if there is a decrease in the value of the resistance which is connected to the drain, there will be a corresponding decrease in the output resistance, and in turn, the overall voltage gain also will decrease. So what conclusion we can give for the common source amplifier without the source resistance is that it mainly suffers from high frequency performance. So that is why this is considered to be one of the poor performing common source amplifier, especially because it does not have a source resist. So let us look into the design of this, and then let us check out later on as to how to compensate these drawbacks by including source resistance connected to the source terminal. So if we look at the design of the common source amplifier without the source resistance, we had obtained the equation for the open circuit voltage gain minus GM RD parallel with R0, and we had the resistance R0, that is the resistance which is connected to the output terminal, to be equal to RD parallel with R0, and GM was computed as equal to mu n COX WIL into VOV, or in short we have it as 2ID by VOV. This is the general equation that we have obtained when we saw the amplifier characteristics in the previous tutorial. And R0 is equal to, this small R0 is equal to VA by ID, and we can obtain the gain of the amplifier if we consider this capital R0. If we consider that, then we have the overall gain, the gain of the amplifier to be equal to minus GM RD parallel with RL parallel with R0. And as we have seen, since the input signal is equal to the input voltage that is applied, the gain will be equal to that of the overall voltage gain of the amplifier. So both these equations will give you the same value. So moving on, we will try to solve a numerical and see the results. So the question says a CS amplifier utilizes a MOSFET which is biased at ID to be equal to 0.25 milliamps with a VOV of 0.25, resistance of 20 kilo ohms, device has a VA of 50 volt. The amplifier is fed with an R signal of 100 kilo ohms and a 20 kilo ohm load is connected at the output. So we need to compute what are these parameters, that is R in, AV not, R not, AV and GV. And to maintain a reasonable linearity, the peak of the input signal is limited to 10% of 2 times VOV. So we need to find out what is the peak of the sine wave voltage at the output. So firstly, what I'm going to do is I'll note down what are the parameters that are given, and then I will try to compute the parameters which have been asked. So here ID is given, VOV, RD, VA, R signal, RL is given, and we know that we have seen that in the common source amplifier without the source resistance the R signal is infinite. So directly I can write the value to be equal to infinite, and we have seen in the design how to compute the value of the transconductance, that is equal to 2ID by VOV. So substitute the value of ID, that is 0.25 divided by VOV, that is 0.25. So milli, and here it is 0.25. So you get the value of GM to be equal to 2 milliamps per volt. Then they have asked you to compute the open circuit voltage gain. So that is equal to minus GM into RD parallel with R0. Now, but we know that RD parallel with R0 is equivalent to that of the output resistance R0, which is given to be equal to 20 kilo ohms. And if we want to compute the gain of the amplifier, we will require the value of R0. That is why that is computed as VA by ID, which is equal to 50 by 0.25 milli, which will give us a value of 200 kilo ohms. Then AV0 is equal to minus GM into the value of RD, that is 20 kilo, it will give us a value of minus 4. So to compute the value of AV, that is equal to the overall voltage gain GV, we compute it as minus GM RD parallel with R0, that is small R0 parallel with RL. And substituting, we get this as 20k parallel with 20k, that is equal to minus 20. You should note that RD parallel with R0, the value is equal to 20k, which we have seen here. And one major observation that we need to do is, we have also been asked to find out what is the peak of the sine wave voltage at the output. So that is mentioned that, and it is mentioned that the peak of the input signal sine wave is limited to 10% of 2 times VOV. So 10% of 2 times VOV means 10 by 100 into 2 multiplied with VOV voltage, that is 0.25 milli, which will give us a value of 0.05 volt. Now we need to compute what is the peak value of the sine wave voltage at the output. So output voltage will be the gain multiplied with the input, and that is VGS dash. So VGS, new value of VGS dash is computed, that is 0.05. when you multiply it with AV, that is minus 20, will give you a value of 1 volt. So moving on, we will go into the common source amplifier with the source resistance. Consider the common source amplifier, the source resistance, which is connected to the source terminal and then connected it to the ground. The equivalent circuit is shown in the figure B, and this equivalent circuit is represented in the form of a T model. So here we have not included are not, because it will complicate the design. And what we have done is we have considered the input resistance to be infinite, because there is no gate current which flows. Moreover, the input signal will be equal to Vi. Because there is a source resistance, if we are going to apply the voltage divider rule to this particular network, you can see that Vi multiplied with the resistance, that is 1 by Gm, divided by the total resistance, 1 by Gm plus resistance Rs. I can also write this as Vi divided by 1 plus Gm into Rs, and I denote this as equation number 1. Now this source resistance can be used to make VGS a very small quantity, so that there is less amount of nonlinear distortion, and the output voltage is obtained by multiplying the control source I by the resistance RD. So we have V0 to be equal to minus I into RD, which is given by equation number 2, and the current I is found using the Ohm's law, and this current I is computed as the input voltage divided by the total resistance, that is 1 by Gm plus Rs, or I can write this as I to be equal to Vi Gm divided by 1 plus Gm into Rs, and I denote this as equation number 3. Like the way we have computed the remaining parameters, that is the open circuit voltage gain, the gain of the amplifier, and the overall gain of the amplifier, we need to compute here as well. We are going to compute the open circuit voltage gain as output voltage by input, and that will be equal to minus Gm into RD divided by 1 plus Gm into Rs. And this factor, that is 1 plus Gm into Rs, is the amount of the negative feedback which is introduced by the source resistance Rs. Because of the negative feedback action, this source resistance Rs is also known as the source degeneration resistance. What that means is that when the input voltage Vi or VGS is increasing, the voltage drop across a source resistance Rs will increase, which in turn will try to reduce the value of VGS. Also, because there is a source resistance connected, the bandwidth performance and the linearity will improve by the same factor, 1 plus Gm into Rs. Or the open circuit voltage gain can be rearranged and represented as shown in the equation 5. So the voltage gain from the gate to the drain will be equal to negation of total resistance in the drain divided by the total resistance in the source. Now when you have the resistance RL which is connected at the output, then you have R0 equal to RD. So we can compute the gain of the amplifier by replacing RD with RD parallel with RL in equation number 4, that is this equation. So RD will be equal to RD parallel with RL. So I can rewrite the gain as minus Gm into RD parallel with RL divided by 1 plus Gm into Rs. So that is represented as equation number 6. Now because the input resistance is infinite, and because the input resistance is infinite and the input signal is equal to V signal, the overall voltage gain GV will be equal to V0 divided by V signal, that is V0 by Vi is equal to AV. So same thing like the previous case, the overall voltage gain will be equal to the gain of the amplifier, and that is represented as equation number 6. So if you observe, the equation number 6 and the equation number 7 are identical. So quickly let us look into the design part and solve a numerical. So if you look at the common source amplifier with the source resistance, the design would be similar way to compute the transconductance. Here the input voltage VGS is computed as Vi divided by 1 plus Gm into Rs, and this term 1 plus Gm into Rs is the amount of the feedback which is provided, or it is also called as the feedback factor. And here the value of R0 will be equal to RD, that is output resistance will be equal to the resistance connected across the drain, and the open circuit voltage gain will be equal to RD divided by 1 plus Gm plus Rs, or I can also write this as AV0 to be equal to minus Gm into RD divided by 1 plus Gm into Rs. And the gain of the amplifier is represented as the parallel combination of the resistance connected across the drain with the load resistance, and the gain of the amplifier will be equal to the overall gain or the circuit. The numerical says that we need to adapt the parameters of the previous problem that we have seen without the source resistance, and they have mentioned the input voltage signal, V signal, to be 50 millivolt and the output voltage to be 1 volt. And they say that for some reason the input signal, V signal, that is of 0.2 volt, and we wish to modify the circuit without changing the value of VGS and keeping the nonlinear distortion from increasing. So we need to compute the value of RS and the value of GV, and also find out what will be the peak signal at the output. So the from the previous parameters, we have GM to be equal to 2 milliamps per volt, and we compute VGS by VI to be equal to 1 by 1 plus GM into RS, which will give us a value of RS to be equal to 1.5 kilo ohms. We know that the overall voltage gain is equal to the gain of the amplifier, and that is computed as minus GM into RD parallel with RL divided by the amount of the feedback. We know the value of RD, that is 20 kilo ohms, and the value of RL, that is 20 kilo ohms. RS is computed as 1.5, GM is computed as 2 milli. So this gives us an overall voltage gain of minus 5, which is also equal to the gain of the amplifier. They have asked us to compute the new value of output voltage, and this has to be computed by considering the new value of the input signal, that is 0.2. And this gives us a value, that is a new value of output voltage, to be equal to 1 volt. Thank you for watching.